Hello everybody and welcome to Thornton Farm. So this is going to be a good day for me because I have finally found a decent compact tractor. This is the John Deere 2032R and it's been out for a while, but I have seen it before, admittedly, but I've never really thought to download it. So I thought I'll give it a go. And what have I been missing here? It's incredible. Now it did actually come with a mower deck. It's quite a pancakey mower deck, but nonetheless it cuts grass. We also have a front loader. This is going to be very handy for yard work, for example, giving a bale to an animal. And also it does come along with a cultivator as well. Quite a small one, but still very handy. So I thought, oh, I'll go for the whole package, then we'll buy everything, as the dealer was doing a deal. Hence the reason why they're called dealers. But yes, this is a good day. We have got a compact tractor. So I'll just start it up, and you can see everything is very highly detailed. Got all of the different controls on here. So yes, I love this. I don't know if it's been sort of shrunk from a bigger tractor because it's got a passenger seat, and I've never really known a compact tractor with a passenger seat before, but either way, still good. Love it. Right, let's get a front loader attached because this is going to be the handiest tool we have. But we might still use it for mowing in the orchards because it comes with the deck. Oh, not too good there. But yeah, look at that. Fits it really well. Now we do need to put the mower deck on too. I think if you just drive over it, it should attach to it. They tend to be called belly mowers or mid-PTO mowers. There we go. And finally, we'll take the cultivator as well. We'll put that on the back too. We'll jump off to do this though. And it's got a drawbar. It's got everything you need. Just like a big tractor, but only condensed into a little compact one. Loving it a lot. Okay, so back to the main yard. What we need to do... Oh, okay. That's weird. There we go. Driving off without the deck. What we need to do today is we need to do a tiny bit of spraying, but not too much, just a bit of herbicide in field number 13. So it won't take very long at all. Now I have actually been playing around with the GPS mod, but, oh, sorry, play out in front of the traffic. But I'm not really too confident with it yet. Not confident enough to use it in a video. So I think, yes, I'm just gonna hold off it for a little while because, you know, I'm still working on it. I said that I was going to use the GPS and I did promise I was going to use it in field 13. But yeah, it's just, I'm working on it. I don't want to mess it up because it's going to make the video really bad because it would be just messing about with the GPS for half an hour. So I want to perfect it first of all. I'm not lying though. You can see I've got it installed. It says there, turn GPS mode on. And I did get it to work, but I just wasn't very good with it, so I do need more practice. This tractor's quite slow. I think my 1220, my compact tractor in real life, that can do 13 miles per hour, so 9 might be a little bit too slow. It's even got a beacon, and the Satex side panel does work with the front loader. We should already have some stuff for that, like a bale spike and pallet fork. So we don't need to buy anything else. We're not really doing too well for money, and the reason for this is because we've been buying so much equipment. And I did say we wouldn't go below £50,000, and I'm actually a bit annoyed that I did that. I get carried away, so we need to get the money back. When we've got these fields ready to go, ready to harvest, we're obviously going to get quite a big cash injection there. We've also got the trees, we've got the sunflowers, which are growing nicely, and the rye. So we actually have quite a bit here. But when we do get the money, we do need to buy some pigs as well. So lots of things still to do on Thornton Farm. It looks like the orchard could do with a little bit of a mow. I won't do it today, but I would like to just turn the deck on and see how it goes. Has it got indicators? It does, look at that. Right, so here we are, and I have actually done one more thing. And this is to make it easier for me because I tend to forget stuff between episodes because I'm always doing more than one map in a week. And what I've done is, this was suggested to me actually, and it's a really good idea. I hadn't heard of it before, but it is called the Note mod, and it pretty much does what it says on the tin. It gives you the ability to add notes to your game. So when I've taken this cultivator off, I'll bring up the note menu. We do need to change to the rear. There we go. and we can detach that. Right, so to get the note menu up, you have to press R on the keyboard and then press R again to be able to press add note. This will enable the cursor. And then you can add anything you want at all, and it's going to be so handy. So for example, if it is something regarding spraying, I can put in the note text area here that in 2 days' time that we need to spray field number 11 with herbicide. And it could be herbicide C or whatever. We do need to look into that, but yes, I think it is herbicide C. So I'll put that there for now. And then you basically just press save. And there it is, spraying. 2 days' time, spray field 11 with herbicide C. And I can get rid of that menu and then bring it up when I need it, and it's still there. So this is a really good thing to have in the game. I've just double checked, and yes, herbicide C is what's required to spray the rye, so that is all good. Right, so let's take this over to the orchard and just quickly give it a go. I'm desperate to use this mower deck. I don't think we'll be keeping it on because it might be a bit obstructive when moving bales or whatever we're going to do. But it's just nice to have. This is the correct way into this field. I used to go up there and it's just way too hilly. So I'm going to start it up here and just see how it goes. Might need four-wheel drive. Oh, look at that, and it even throws it out the side where the discharge chute is. That is so good. Oh, we don't want to tip it over. It's growing back. So you could actually make like a row, like a swath, by doing it this way. So I wonder if we go around again, would it then move it across into the centre like it would do in real life? Go around once more. This is pretty good. Right, so if I go here. Kind of. I don't think it is moving it. But still, the idea is so good. Wow. This is a decent mod. I'll put the link below. It was actually very hard to find, but I have finally found the link to it. Because I saw it in a video about... must have been about a year and a bit ago, just over a year ago, and I searched for it then, and I forgot the model number, so I just gave up. But now I found it once again, and this is a mod you can't really do without on a small farm. We might even have to get it onto our new map, onto the Norwegian map, so yes, this is something we're going to have to keep. Let's just drive it over here. Drop the deck off somewhere, not really too sure the best place to put it. Because obviously all of these sheds are taken up with tractors. Maybe here actually, in front of the wheelbarrow. There we go. So now it is just a really handy tractor with a front loader. We're going to park it up out of the way because we don't need it again at the moment. And we need to just go and jump into the sprayer. So if anybody has any suggestions for the GPS, because I'm doing okay, but like I say, struggling a bit, then please do let me know, because it is, in my opinion, quite a difficult mod to get used to. I never used it in FS13, so that's why I'm new to it. I know it's been out for a long time, but I never really plucked up the courage to use it, and I probably should have done. Anyway, I think the sprayer is just around here. It should be in a shed. Yeah, there it is. Next to the good old 698. Now, we're going to spray. This is going to be a sunflower field, so the herbicide we spray will have to be the correct one for the job. And I've just got my list here as usual to make sure I don't go and kill it off by accident. And herbicide C would be the incorrect chemical for this. We need herbicide A or B. It doesn't matter which one. You can go for either. So as long as I put one of those two in there, we should be okay. Now again, this is going to be a bit of a problem with the money, because this is going to affect the price. Because we currently have NPK, which is obviously the fertilizer, and that is going to be replaced by this herbicide, and the price is most likely going to be more expensive than what the fertilizer is. So we're just going to have to wait and see, hope for the best. I do need to give the lime mod a go as well, because we have had lime in quite a few maps, and I've never really used it. I probably should do. Right, so we should, yes, there we go, we can cycle through. Now herbicide C, this is just a standard herbicide, the same with A and B. But if you have a double dose, it's, I think it's probably twice the price, I'm not too sure. Actually, amazingly, A and B are different prices. So I'm guessing they're different strengths. So I think we'll probably just go with A to begin with, but possibly a double dose of it. Although, that is very expensive. No, I think we'll have to go with just A on its own. And we do need to top it up a bit as well. This is tough. This really is a tough map to actually manage because everything is so expensive. We're still using the old Mega Combine just there. Having said that though, I think we probably do have way too many tractors because I think, yeah, we've got a lot of stuff here. We might have to just sell something, but that is not what I want to do. We still have to pay off this sprayer. The agreement is £5,000 per week, so we're okay at the moment, but very soon we do need to give them £5,000. This will at least prevent the weeds for a short period of time. It's probably about a day and a half. I think the double dose is 3 days, so yeah, it should be about a day and a half. But luckily, in our favour, we are playing in real time, so it does make it easier. I'm gonna lower the back there. Lower the boom. And we'll begin. So this sprayer, as I've said before, is actually quite a slow sprayer. If it was up to me, I'd have it a bit faster, but you can't do without editing the files for it. There are other versions of it, I know about that, but yeah, it's not ideal because we've already bought this one and in the end we'd lose money. Now what I probably should be doing is staying pretty straight on here because we're crushing some of the crops. That is inevitable as we have the destroy crop mod on. Comes with the drive control, but I could reduce it a bit. If we just get rid of one row either side, then it'd be a lot better. And for down here, I think if we go down here, you can see like an obvious tram line to go down, so that's what we'll continue on. It's amazing, I get quite a lot of mixed comments in my videos. Like, some people say do the headland first, and then some people say do the headland last. So I've said this before, and it just gets really confusing because you're being told two different things, and either could be right or wrong. So it is quite challenging. So I think if I just do it my own way, a few people have said just do it your own way, then that is the best thing to do. After all, it should still work. The chemical is still going to be applied. It's just we might crush a few more crops. You can see in the wing mirror there, we're actually doing pretty well. And I think if we turn about here and head down this line, that should be, yeah, we could go across a bit more. Just slightly. This should be the best one to go down now. Perfect, right. So if we just get this field finished off, then it should be good enough until it's ready. We're actually doing pretty well. The growth stage is probably stage 2 or 3, so there isn't too much further to go. Although, yes, there is still the sunflowers. You've got to get the heads and then you've got to let them dry off and die off. So they're not there yet, obviously, but they are progressing very nicely. Right, and this time if we go across here and then we can just go up and down, it will be dead easy. This is a piece of cake using this. I love the sprayer. Somebody did say we should probably get rid of the smaller Triton or Triton sprayer because we don't really need it anymore as we have this, and that is a good point actually. It would come in handy for the small fields, but then really we can choose this. It's just not going to take very long to do. We've got a few weeds in here, a bit of coverage, but on the whole this has worked pretty well. And then we can go back down here again. This is working really well. Better than usual. I think just having the lines of the sunflowers makes it a lot easier. You don't really need GPS, well that might infuriate a few people saying that, but I actually do prefer not using it. I was reading Funky Farmer's comments again. He is such a good YouTuber. Can't really help but mention him. because he does these real life videos on his farm. Really good, high quality and very educational. And yeah, he actually replied to someone else's comment, and somebody said, nice use of GPS or something. This was for, I think, either fertilizer spreading or spraying. And he just said, I don't need GPS because I've got 25 years of knowledge or 25 years of experience. And it's true, I think, really. Unless it's like a big farm, you don't really need it. Although, yes, it's very helpful. I think for the smaller farms, it's not 100% necessary. But obviously, I'm no expert, so I can't really say that with too much confidence. Okay, we could be slightly further over, but I don't really like changing lanes when we're in the field. We crush way too many crops. But I think this field is progressing very nicely. The nutrients is looking fantastic. The soil moisture is a bit too high. It's because we've had a lot of rain recently. But the sun should dry it out, and we should finish off with the optimum moisture. And really, we just have to wait until it's ready. I'm going to do more sunflowers in future. It's a really good crop to do. The multi-fruit mod on a whole is just brilliant. Okay, where's our turning? There it is. We haven't really crushed much at all. And somewhere in here we want to go. I think probably in here. Yeah, that'll do. And that, I think, is the end of the field. So this has actually worked very well. Very impressed by it. And we still have 20% left in the tank. Really good. Let's get it folded up. And I think what we're going to do is we're going to take the drone up, because I'd love to see how the tram lines have been laid out. Obviously, we're not going to get it perfect because the field isn't exactly the right size for the boom. But I think it should be okay. Just get it folded up. And we'll head back. So we'll put it back into the shed. And I really am loving Thornton Farm. I think you've got to have the right mixture. You've got to be doing two maps at the same time. A smaller map, so you can stick with the older or possibly vintage equipment, and also the smaller fields. And also a big map like Thornton Farm, where you just can't really resist using the massive equipment. I think the drill there is a bit of a giveaway. That is quite a big piece of kit and very expensive. That is where some of our money has gone, a big chunk of it. But into the shed it goes. We'll drop it off there, switch the engine off, and we'll send the drone up. I don't think we'll be going as high as that plane though. Okay, we've just converted into a drone. Sorry. Oh, yes, we've just converted ourselves into a drone. We're going to send ourselves up here. Let's go. This is a bit slow. There we go. We're picking up speed. So what does it look like from above? From a distance it looks okay. It's a bit scruffy leaving the field. And a bit scruffy on that corner there. But I think really that isn't too bad. I mean, it's not perfect. But like I say, it's because of the boom width on the sprayer. It's not exactly right for the field, but it never would be. The agroforestry field with Stonehenge behind. That's looking okay. And feel whoa, looks like some kind of acid or something. But that is the rye. I think it's probably just got like a different texture colour from above. It's okay. We have not produced a pool of toxic waste. I'll have to land over here just to make sure. Let's just land a bit quicker. There we go. It's looking okay from here. It's a very, like a limey green colour, and there are quite a few weeds in here too. So as I did say, we did post a thing in the notes, and it does say, in 2 days time, spray field 11 with herbicide C. But I might change that actually, because I think that might be a bit too long. Can you edit it? I think, yes, you can. Good. I think in 1 day time, I think, oh, you have to rewrite it, do you? You have to rewrite it. Okay. Well, it's still good. Let me just delete this and write 1 day, field 11, and we want herbicide C. Good, so we'll save that and we'll know for later on. Okay, remove the notes and let's head back over there. As I've said before, I'm hoping to get some new content on the channel, and I'm still looking to get faster internet. I keep saying it's going to happen. I am making progress now, and I should have faster internet. Nothing super fast or anything like that, because it's satellite. But the maximum speed I could possibly get in my area, and that should be within the next month. So, really hoping this is going to make a dramatic difference to the amount of videos I post. I think they'll probably all be the same length as they are now, but there'll be more of them. So, looking forward to it, I really am, and I'm hoping to do different games as well. It just depends what speed I actually do get. The download's going to be pretty decent compared to what I've got, of course. I've got currently between 3 and 4 megabits per second download, and it should be at least, well, it should be about 15, I think. But compared to fibre optic, that's nothing. And upload, you might think this is slow, and I guess it is, 2 megabits per second upload. But if you compare that to what I've got now, which is 0.2, that is a big difference. So I can definitely work with that. I can get some more content out for you, and we should be able to expand this channel even more. So this is going to be good. Ah, that is a bit of an issue. If you press R, that is the button for the notes, but it's also the button to open the door. So I'm going to have to change the key binding for that. I think we'll just put this away, and we'll call it a day for now, because I do need to wait for the crops to progress. We don't have too much to do, as obviously the money is low, and without either selling more crops or harvesting some, we're going to find it quite hard to actually find any money. I will just check though, do we have anything in storage? Yeah, we've got a bit of canola, so we could sell that when the price is right. Anyway, that is it for today. Hopefully you've enjoyed the video. Loving the compact tractor, and I think we're doing okay now with field 13. Things are progressing nicer than on Knaveswell. I did actually kill off half the field, so that wasn't too good. Or at least they might as well have been dead, as the nutrients were 0%. But still, this farm is progressing better than that. Times 6 nitrogen and times 3 PK, so that's pretty good. Okay, so yeah, that is it for today, and please do stay tuned for tomorrow's video. See you again soon. Bye for now.